美国西雅图多次被票选为世界上最适合人类居住的城市，居民的生活水准也普遍的高。然而西雅图却也有很多的游民露宿街头，慈善团体会定期发放围巾、外套等等，就独独是没有人发放过袜子。于是西雅图的慈济志工突发奇想，发起了送袜子给街友的活动。这一双简单的袜子透过恭恭敬敬的给予，令街友感到相当惊喜，人情味也让这个城市更宜居、更温暖。
在全美国，西雅图算是 the best living 的城市，而且很多大公司在西雅图，所以应该是一个经济很好、看不到贫穷人的一个城市。但是你特别是晚上下班，你开车回家，你就可以看到路边，哎，已经有一些 homeless。
I just back like this. Sometimes I put the covers over my head, but sometimes I don't. But this keeps all the rats and stuff out.
大概九年前，每个星期六，我们一定有七八个或十几个慈青来做纸类环保回收。然后八年前吧，他们就决定，哎，我们是不是要把这些做环保所赚来的钱来回馈西雅图呢？
Okay, so we're wrapping the socks so that they're easier to give to the homeless, and then also at the same time putting the city's logo on it so that they know that we are city.
And so we ended up going to the local homeless shelter and we asked the people who were in charge there, what do they want? And they were saying that socks are really needed. We never saw anyone distribute socks. We always saw people distribute food. There's a lot of food. There's some clothing drives, some blankets, but we never heard of a socks drive.
Homeless 也没有固定的地方可以洗衣服，所以袜子穿久了，穿了几天，他们唯一的办法就是丢掉。
And also, especially in Seattle, we get a lot of rain, and so socks do get wet really quickly.
、yeah, thank you for coming. So all together at the same time. So one.Two, three. Thank you.
今天我们准备了大概200双的袜子，而且有一点点改变方式。慈青排排站，然后 homeless 也是排排站，然后慈青就包，好像我们慈济一般的赈灾的发放一样。
So when we have a smaller distribution event, they can experience giving somebody materials that there's a necessity for them.
When we are going out to distribute socks today, it's not like we're doing this, like that's a good thing to do.
Sometimes last night it got kind of cold and I had no socks on my feet, so these are coming in.
Well, I'm type 2 diabetic, I gotta keep my feet dry and clean.
Actually, I've been seeing a lot of them already wearing our socks and that made me really happy, you know, it shows they really need it.
It make me a whole day, I'll be able to move around and hopefully walk to church later on. It's just a blessing.